Hey everyone, it's Ryan with SacramentoAppraisalBlog.com, and today I wanted to talk about where the Sacramento market is at. I've been asked a lot lately from quite a few people, what's the market doing? Is it starting to tank? Is this a seasonal slowdown? What is going on out there? And so I wanted to provide some context by looking at the numbers, okay? This isn't just my feelings, but let's look at stats. We're going to look at three things. We're going to look at housing inventory, prices, and sales volume. But not only that, I want us to look at 2005 stats also when the real estate bubble burst, because I think there's some clues in there to help answer the question, what does it look like when a market begins to tank versus a market that is slowing down for the season? So I hope this will be helpful. This will be a little longer, probably 10 minutes or so. And this is just off the cuff, although I do have a presentation that I sort of gave this morning in an office, added a few slides, but let's jump in. So last week, a real estate agent emailed me and said, "Hey, I just got this from my brokerage. What's going on? The message is that the median price is down, and that's a sign that the market is starting to turn." Kind of a fear-based thing going, "Uh-oh, you better prepare for the future." And I said, "That's actually false." Okay, the median price being down from 375 to 370 so far in Sacramento County is kind of what we would expect at this time of year. Okay, here's what the median price has looked like since 2013. And you see this very cyclical nature, okay, where values are up in the spring and then they sort of level off in summer and then they decline in the fall. Okay, like clockwork every single year. And what happens though is that when the fall season comes and the market slows, I remember vividly ever since 2013, we start to have people say the market bubble is here. The market's going to correct. We're going to see a huge change. And so there's like these prophecies that occur. And then every year, person comes back and makes the same prediction. And at some point, the person's probably going to be right. Okay. But at the same time, you kind of wonder about credibility though too. Okay, and here's the median price in the Sacramento region. You can see the same cyclical nature, and you can see right now that prices have definitely softened. And but again, is that really a surprise? No, that's about what we'd expect to see happen in the region, in the county, in neighborhoods, all over the place. So here are some of the signs of a softening market. Okay, we see lots of different things. These are some of the main ones. We see days on market increasing where it takes longer to sell. We see less offers on properties. Definitely seeing that today. Less traffic for listings, sellers giving more credits to buyers, a declining sales to list price ratio. See more price reductions. Listings are priced lower than sales. Sales are starting to come in lower. An increase of housing inventory. Okay, all of these things and even some more metrics. This is what we would expect to see in a typical fall season. I'd say we're really seeing just about all these things in one degree or another. Okay, so now let's look real quick at 2005 and then we'll jump into some other stats today. What was the market like back then? What can we glean and maybe think about for today? So first of all, what happened to inventory in 2005? Well, the bubble officially popped, we'd say, in August of 2005, and you can see inventory between August and November doubled. Okay, it went from 2.5 months to 5 months. Okay, so a very quick increase of listings in the market. All right, and then over the course of 1 year, from August 2005 to August 2006, housing inventory actually tripled. And that is huge to have such a dramatic change in inventory. Okay, so by the end of the 1 year period, there was an 8 month supply of homes for sale on the market. So eight months worth of homes, and before there were only 2.5 months worth of homes. What a huge change. Okay, but what about sales volume? What was happening to sales volume? Well, when the market burst, it wasn't just inventory that began to increase. I mean, we had more listings on the market, but one of the reasons why there were more listings is because properties stopped selling. Okay, over 1 year, sales volume declined by 43%. All right, this is absolutely enormous. Here's another way to look at it. Okay, here's listings in light green. You can see even there's like this seasonal element where at the end of the year you see listings dip. So even though the market's starting to decline, but then you see this exponential increase in listings and sales volume in dark green, you see just begins to tank. Okay. So there were 2,100 sales in August 2005 and only 1,200 in August 2006. What a difference. Now, here's something really important though. Because during this time, the bubble's starting to burst, and we're not seeing that much change in prices, though. Okay, so over this same time period, when inventory tripled and sales volume declined by 43%, you see the average price only declined by 4%, and the median price only declined by 6%. So this reminds us if we are only looking at prices, we might actually miss the market. Okay, if we're looking to the median price to tell us what the market's doing, we might miss the actual trend. Okay, and so we have to look to changes in the market in the listings first, in the amount of pendings, and the sentiment among, buyers and sellers. What's the word on the street? We will see the market change in those ways before we see anything else. And what I would say is this: let's look for a substantial change in inventory and a more substantial change in sales volume rather than just minor changes. Okay, if the market was to crash, we would expect to see something probably a little bit more dramatic. All right, so it begs the question though, which is so important for today, for sellers especially, what tells us more about the current market? Is it sales or is it listings? Usually, when I ask this in a real estate office, I often hear sales, and I think agents are right because properties that have actually sold mean something. Okay, there's a property that's been on the market for 8 years in MLS. That does not mean anything. Okay, it's probably really overpriced or there's some huge issue going on. That listing means absolutely nothing. I want to see what is actually sold because that means that buyers are biting at that level. But here's the deal. What tells us about the current market? I would say it's going to be the listings. Now, the market's softening right now. And really pay attention to this. Sales are like historical documents. They tell us what the market used to be like when the sales got into contract 30, 60 to 90 days ago. All right, what's the market like right now? Well, if the market's softer, we're going to see a softness and maybe lower prices by listings that are getting into contract that are similar, and probably at lower levels. Okay, the temptation is for sellers to look to the highest prices from the spring and expect this Bay Area unicorn buyer to drop in and pay cash at that level, but you gotta look to the current market in the listings to see the change. Okay, the same exact thing happened when the real estate bubble burst. We saw the change in the listings, not so much in the sales price. Okay, and so this similar thing happens on a micro level in neighborhoods, and so that's why we have to look into the listings. Does that make sense? If not, let me know. But housing supply is up 29% this year in Sacramento County. You can see that definitely there's been an increase. Same thing in the region, about the same numbers. Part of the reason why this number sounds so sensational, though, is that housing inventory was just a lot lower and it's been anemic for so many years. So, take that with a grain of salt. Don't freak out too much at that magnificent number. So, but the question becomes, should we be concerned that we have over 3,000 listings right now? You can see last year, here's listings in light green. You can see listings at the same time were about 2,400, and so we have about 600 more listings this year. That's significant. That's really huge. And I think that's one reason why the market feels so much different and so much more dull this year compared to last year. So should we be concerned? Well, here's some context. My sense is that we have to look, and sorry, I cut off the screen a little bit. It keeps going up, just one more tick. I should have expanded the screen, but live and learn. My sense is that we start to look at 3,000 listings and go, oh my gosh, this is so much higher than last year. And it really is, but I think sometimes in real estate, we're so focused on 1 year of data, we have to take a little bit of a wider look so we can capture the trend. Okay. Honestly, the last couple years, the fall market has not been very dull. It's felt a little bit more flat than not, okay? But in 2014, the fall market was extremely dull. In fact, a lot of people thought that the market was going to change then. They felt like the bubble really was going to burst or things were going to turn because properties simply stopped selling at that time to a certain extent, okay? They were not commanding the same prices as they were in the spring or late summer. It was really, really obvious, okay? And so, historically speaking, there are some falls that are more dull than others. And at best, right now, it looks like we're poised to have one of those dull falls. Okay, then at worst, we would be in a position where the market can begin to change if this rate of listings continues. Okay, right now, it looks like we've had about 3,000 listings. It looks like that may have crested, okay? And if it has for the season, then maybe we'll persist to have a normal seasonal trend. We need a little bit more time to really see that if we're honest, okay? But I would just say keep in mind that yes, the market's a lot more dull than it was these last couple years, and so it's important to not take last year's mentality and to project it onto this year because we have a market like this right here so far for the season. So does that make sense? Keep that in mind. Here's current inventory levels in Sacramento County. You can see this increase lately, but let's look at the context though, because inventory is still down from where it was in 2014 and 2015. Okay, we had such an anemic supply of inventory that I think that the market is very used to that lower supply, and so the more inventory we get right now, the market really feels it. And so, even though we're at about 1.85 months right now of housing supply, that's historically low. I think the market feels pretty soft. Okay. And in a lot of times, we say that a normal market is 5 months of houses for sale. That's not true anymore. It might have been true in the past. It might be true in different markets throughout the country. It's absolutely not true in Sacramento County or the Sacramento region, okay? In the region, this is the first time we've had up to 2 months of housing supply for 3 years. And I think the market really feels it. We go like, wow, what a difference. Even my wife, who doesn't work in real estate, she's noticing more listings on, the Zillow app or when we're driving around town. Anecdotally, she's just noticing, wow, there are definitely more listings on the market. Okay, so it's transitioning from a seller's market to a buyer's market, and we're sort of living in the tension of that right now. Sales volume was down 6% last month in the region and 2.5% in Sacramento County. And so we ask, is that a problem? And here's the thing. I showed you in 2005 when the market really began to change. One of the changes that occurred wasn't necessarily with prices first, it was with listings increasing and sales beginning to drop. Now, here's the thing. In Sacramento County, or in the region, a 6% drop. I mean, it means something, but I think it's okay to admit that we had a weak August. And if we saw sales volume consistently drop, every single month, then I would say that yes, the market really is starting to change in a bigger way. Okay, that's a big deal. All right. But here's some things to consider. Here's some stats. What does sales volume normally happen? What normally happens in the fall? September through December is in black each year. So 2014, 2015, 16, 17. And right here, you can see that every year, September through December, you see that sales volume drops. And that's exactly what we would see happen, or what we expect to see happen this year. Okay. And so let's look for that. But let's really pay attention to year-over-year declines because, like I said, if that does become an issue, then that could be a sign that the market is making a bigger change. But so far, let me show you some stats. Okay, this is where we have to read headlines, but we really have to know the stats. Okay, in August sales in 2018, you can compare it to 3 other years. Definitely above 2015, not too far below last year at all. But you could see this is Sacramento County. I mean, only 2.5% different, but it was a little bit of a weaker August for sure. But you can see when we look at January through August sales volume is actually up 1% in the region. Okay? Sales volume is hardly down when you consider the entire past 12 months in Sacramento County. Okay? So it's important not just to give laser focus to say what happened August 2018 versus August 2017. we've got to look at other ways to look at volume also, and we can kind of see that, hey, it's been a stronger year of volume so far. We don't have this sense where the market is utterly falling, okay? Volume has been in a rhythm and it's finding the groove. Now, look, if it was down 2% last month or 5%, in I think it was July, I mean, that can start to add up, and if we see that over time, that's a trend, and we've got to pay attention to that. The danger is if we look at really old stats from the past year, it can hide the trend that's happening right now. So I hope that's not too technical, but we really have to pay attention to right now. But let's not forget to look at everything. Okay, here's the sales volume in the region, and you can see a very similar dynamic where volume is up January through August. It was a weaker August though, August 2018. But overall, the past 12 months of sales, it's been really steady. Okay. Now, if we have that, 7% decline or 6% decline every single month, then we're going to start to see these numbers impacted over time. We don't see any real change right now, but again, that's something to watch. So here's one big thought, and I think this might be the last slide. That momentum is slowing in the market. Okay, I wanted to show you, here's some regional price differences. When we compare August this year with August last year, you see that most price metrics are up 4 to 5%. Now, okay, so the market's still up, values increased this year, but one of the things that's different is that in years past, I saw these price changes were easily 7 to 10%, probably usually 7 to 9% or so for years it's been. And so what we're starting to see is we're starting to see the rate of appreciation slow down, and that shows us that momentum in the market is slowing. What does that mean for the future? I mean, I don't know. I don't think anyone really knows. We just know that the market as a whole is slowing, and I mean, we're certainly having issues with affordability. Values can only go so high as interest rates rise. Also, I mean, these are all things that could certainly impact momentum. So, something to keep in mind and watch. Okay, this is the last slide. The 24-hour market watch in MLS, we see a lot of price reductions, and I think that I want to note that when the market slows, we definitely see price reductions. But in 2014, around this time of year, we were seeing more like almost 400 price reductions every single day. And so we've forgotten, I think, what it's like to have a really dull fall in Sacramento because we haven't had one in a number of years. And so I'm not trying to sugarcoat stats. I'm only trying to pull back some perspective and say, at the best, we're poised to have a dull fall these next few months. So let's expect for price reductions to increase, but historically, let's remember that I think that there's some room in the market to see these reductions go up. Okay, these reductions are starting to look higher than last year. That totally makes sense though. It's ex what we would expect to see since the market is much more dull this year so far. Okay, so let's pay attention to those 2014 stats and see what happens this year. Some quick tips: sellers price according to similar homes that are getting into contract. Okay, be really careful about looking to the highest sales from the spring. Okay, two, know what the market normally does during the fall. Okay, this will help you know if it's a seasonal slowing or something else. And so ask yourself, what does the market normally do in September? Then when October starts, what does the market normally do this month? Okay, and be able to know those stats. What happens with inventory or sales volume or prices? Okay, that way you can spot whether something is abnormal or not. Okay, like I said, it's normal for inventory to increase and it's normal for listings to increase, but if we see hundreds of listings keep hitting the market and they're not absorbed, then that would be abnormal. That would be a problem. But if the listings crest right now at 3,000 and begin to subside, then maybe we chalk it up to a dull fall season. Okay. Thirdly, live in the tension of not knowing everything now. Okay. There are no true real estate profits. Okay. And we have to live in the tension of not knowing the future exactly and just being okay with that. Okay. I keep saying like this, that real estate stats are a bit like dating. Okay. Very rarely will you date someone and on the first date you just know that you're going to marry them. Okay, unless you're my grandparents. They did one of those things and they were married 3 weeks later. But otherwise, you need time to figure out a relationship. Where is this relationship going to go? You got to get to know the other person, okay? And the same thing happens with real estate stats, where we don't have the full picture right now, okay? And live in the tension of that is okay, all right? And we will begin to know that full picture over time. And right now, we're in a place where the market's slowing, and it's just going to benefit us the more data we get. Okay, so keep conversation open. Keep talking to real estate professionals. Keep those channels open. Last but not least, know the stats well enough to cut through the hype of national or local news stories. Okay, really important because we have some hype out there. It's easy to say things about the market or to make claims and to say that the market's beginning to tank because the median price is down, but that's hype. Because that normally happens, okay? That's not credible, okay? So let's know our stuff. And I hope that was helpful. I have a blog. You can check it out if you wish. Subscribe if you wish. This is me, my contact information if you ever want to reach out. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Sorry that was 20 minutes, but hey, I hope it was worth it. So thanks so much for your time. Take care.